guys, so today I want to do a full laundry with me video, but we're also going to be talking about New Year's goals, New Year's resolutions, just different plans that I have that our family has for the upcoming New Year 2020, which sounds crazy to even say the word 2020. That's just insane in and of itself. But yeah, let's hop right in and talk a little bit about some of the stuff that we have on the books for this coming year. So the first thing that's not really a plan at all, it's more like a lack of a plan, is that we don't have any house projects to do this year. We don't have any home improvement things that are like on the list of things to do. We've lived in this house since 2015, and like every spring we always have something going on, some kind of home improvement type thing going on. Like we've finished our basement, we've put flooring in different bathrooms of the house, we built like our concrete patio thing in the backyard and did some landscaping and stuff. So we've always had something to do around the house, and next year we don't have anything planned. This coming year, 2020, there's nothing on the books for home improvement stuff. And so that actually feels really good, knowing that we don't have like a big project that's like just waiting there for us. Another goal of this year is to pay off our house. We should have our mortgage taken care of in the next couple of months. And I will be putting out a video once that time comes, more about how we have been able to pay off our house so quickly and all that good stuff. So keep a lookout for a video like that coming in the future once we officially have this thing paid for. But that's gonna be one of the big exciting things that happen in this coming year. And along with that, our next big purchase is going to be a new car. I have owned my car since I was 17, and it's a 2002 vehicle, so I definitely need a bigger car. I just need something that's a little newer and not so. My car is definitely like a, you know, drive to town and back kind of car. Like I wouldn't trust it if I had to drive 100 miles a day, you know, but it's fine for what I need it to do, right? So that's one big thing. Hopefully this coming year I'll be able to get not like a new car, but just like a new to me car. So along with that, I said I needed a bigger car because one day, hopefully, we'll be able to have a new baby. But this year, knock on wood, is not gonna be that year. So far, the plan is we don't wanna have a new baby until the next year, 2021. But I mean, as you guys know, anything can happen. So right as of right now, the plan is not to have a new baby in 2020. So that's one thing, another plan that's not really a plan. One thing I would like to do this year is to take an anniversary trip, me and my husband. It will be our 5-year anniversary this June. And we didn't take a honeymoon or anything. We didn't do anything special when we got married. We had a very low-key wedding to begin with. But I would really like to take a trip, just me and him, and leave the boys with the grandmas for a few days. I think that would be super nice. We don't have anything like totally planned out or for sure or anything, but that's just something that I have mentioned over the last year or so that I think I would like us to do some kind of trip, just the two of us. And we're super duper fortunate to have all of our family right here in town with us, both my sisters and my parents and my husband's parents. My husband's mom and her husband live within 5 minutes of us. We all live in the same town. So I am super duper lucky to be able to have all those different people who would be willing or able to kind of like chip in and watch the boys maybe only a couple days with this grandma and a couple days with this grandma or something like that while we were gone on a vacation. That would be super duper nice. So along with not planning to have a new baby, I would really like to get back to my actual pre-pregnancy weight. I've been really terrible about things lately, and I know I just need to like buckle down and get it taken care of. I've been hovering around, I'm probably about 10, maybe 10 to 15 pounds more than I need to be at this point. 10 to 15 pounds over what I was before I got pregnant with Calvin, my first pregnancy. So I would like to get back to my actual pre-pregnancy weight, but that's gonna be one of the goals. I know this is everybody's New Year goal, right? To lose weight and get fit, blah, 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 blah. Eat better, work out, blah, blah, blah. But I do love that Yoga with Adrian, she's a YouTube channel here, and I'm sure you guys know who she is. She always puts out like a 30-day January, like yoga every day kind of challenge, like what would you call that, like a series, and I love doing those. I love seeing them. I come out the last couple years, I've seen them and have tried to kind of get into them, but I definitely want to like really try really hard to do every single day this year, this coming 2020. But I've also been the last month or so really been a lot better about working out, so at least I'm not like, you know, I'm gonna wait till the first of the year or whatever. I've been like doing it for a month or so now, so I feel like that's at least a little bit of prep that's gonna make me maybe a little more successful come the new year, since I've already been trying to do better about working out. I've been working out probably, I like to do like 2 or 3 days and then a break day, and so I've been doing that pretty consistently for about a month now, and yeah, it's been pretty awesome, so that's been great. And I have not seen any weight loss, so that's just wonderful. One thing I do wonder, I've been contemplating whether or not I want to wean Eren. He will be 2 in March on St. Patrick's Day of this year. And part of me kind of wants to wean him down just because I'm like kind of tired of it. But there's also like this little part in the back of my mind that's like, you've been pregnant or breastfeeding for, yeah, like 4.5 years now. And I wonder if not having the breastfeeding hormones would help me lose that weight. I just feel like I've been stuck for so long that it has to be something. I just feel like there are some people who breastfeeding either helps them lose weight or it helps them hold on to the weight. And I just feel with my heart that I am one of the people who it just makes me hold on to the weight. And so I would kind of like to see what it would be like to not be nursing for a couple of months before we decide to try for the next baby, so I can see if I can actually lose the weight. If it's really like, then I'll know like, oh, it's just the stupid hormones or OMG, I need to work like extra freaking hard, you know? So I would like to know that, but I'm still totally on the fence about weaning Eren. I don't know, I love him. I love giving him the boobie. I know he loves his boobie a lot, but some days I'm just like, OMG, that's enough of that. So those are all of just my personal plans for the coming year. Now let's talk a little bit about this channel in particular, about my YouTubing stuff. So what's my list say? It says continue to keep a consistent upload schedule. I've been doing a very consistent upload schedule for a very long time now. I do Sundays, Tuesdays, and Thursdays, and I'm going to continue doing Sundays, Tuesdays, and Thursdays. Sundays tend to be cloth diaper related stuff. The other days are just other stuff. There's not really a theme for the other days necessarily. But I have been doing the Vlogmas this year, which has been a lot of work, and I did not make it all the way through New Year's. Like I said at the beginning that I would either go till Christmas or go till New Year's making a video every single day, and Christmas is enough. And don't get me wrong, I love doing cloth diaper videos. I love talking about cloth diapers. I love me some cloth diapers. But how many cloth diaper videos can one person make? I'm like really asking. Like I feel like there has to be an end to this sometime. There's only so many things I can say about cloth diapering, right? But I mean, at this point, I always have video ideas. I always have stuff that I'm writing down, stuff that I'm taking notes on, ideas that I just like think of, and I have to, like, you know, write it down, don't forget about that. And then like one day I just feel inspired to film it. Like I have not found myself in a situation where I don't have any more ideas, and I know it has to be coming soon, right? There has to be a point where, you know, I've given as much as I can to the cloth world. So let me know if you guys have any other video ideas, anything in particular, any kind of topics you would like to hear me discuss on any videos here on this channel, anything motherhood or family or whatever you guys want to hear. Let me know in the comments down below, because I feel like one day I'm going to run out of video ideas. And I particularly feel that way after going through Vlogmas and putting up a video every single day for 25 days. So I do hope you guys enjoyed this video. Let me know what your plans for the new year are down below, and I will talk to you guys next time. Bye.